share your word. Lord, even as we have come this day, we pray, Holy Spirit, that you speak to our hearts. We pray, Holy Spirit, that you give us interpretation and you give us understanding. We commit each and every heart for God that are prepared to receive your word today. Thank you. Take all the praises and take all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
You may have your seat. Hallelujah. Somebody will take in sin, but they can see. You know, always, Pastor Scarborough will be looking for. Amen. The joy that we cannot get out there, we get it in here. So every time we come in His presence, this is why the psalmist David said, let us enter His gate with praise and with thanksgiving. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want to bless God for the opportunity given me today being become a minister. I see it as a privilege and I see it as an opportunity. If you have a Bible, and I guess you have, let's turn to the book of Romans, chapter 12. Somebody was telling me that I'm becoming so much, I don't know, to be a professor. But I believe that every time the Holy Spirit leads me, is what I do. Sometimes I preach. Sometimes, you know, I'm called as a teacher. And in this last day, I know for what I believe and I'm convinced in my spirit that God's people need to hear is teaching. They need more of teaching than of preaching. Please do not get me wrong, but I believe this is the purpose for which God had to commend the prophet Jeremiah that in the last day he will raise up teaching priests. And according to Isaiah, we come to understand. The Bible says, for a long season, Israel have been with all the true God and with all the teaching priests. So therefore, the people did evil in the sight of the Lord. But then when Ezra the priest, one of the writers of the Bible, Ezra was very much prophetic, but he was a teacher. He was the one that led the first batch of captivity, the captives from Egypt, from Babylon. Ezra is the one who wrote the book of 1 Chronicles and 2 Chronicles. And he wrote the book of Ezra also. But he was a teacher. And when he went back to Jerusalem, the Bible said he began to teach the people. And while he was teaching them, the Spirit of God began to minister to their hearts. And every one of them gave themselves to the Lord. And he entered an oath that hey, whosoever that will not serve the Lord God of Israel, it should be soon to death. Amen. So I believe in the teaching ministry so much. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Having said that, Romans chapter 12, verse 2. Romans chapter 12, verse 2. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. It is your own Bible online, the world mind. By the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is the good. It is the own Bible online, that word good. And acceptable, one another word acceptable, and perfect will of God. I read that again. Be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is the good, acceptable, and perfect will of God. And so, if you ask for anything, I will give you a thing I entitled the instrument for successful life, the mind. The instrument for successful life is the mind. Somebody say the mind. Proverbs chapter 23 verse 7 says, as the man thinketh in his heart, so is he. And that word thinketh in his heart also refers to the mind. The mind. So basically, we are going to be dealing with the mind today as we are in our year of amazing testimony. God is prepared, God is committed, and God is ever ready to bring to pass everything that He has said. For a man of faith, that whenever God speaks, before He speaks, He has already done it. So I want us to understand, as this year has been declared unto us as the year of our amazing testimony, we have a work to be done. God has given us an instrument. And what is the instrument? The instrument is our mind. Many a time Christians don't know that their mind has a major role to play when it comes to Christianity and it comes to work with God. Then the question is, what is the mind? I will give you two definitions. I will give you the general definition, and I will give you the scientific definition, and we dive into it. What is the mind? The mind is the faculty of mere reasoning and thoughts. The mind is the faculty of mere reasoning and thoughts. It holds the power of imagination, recognition, appreciation, and is responsible for processing feelings and emotion, resulting into attitude and action. That is the general definition. I read that again. The mind is the faculty of mere reasoning and thoughts. It holds the power of imagination, recognition, appreciation, and is responsible for processing feelings and emotion, resulting into attitude and action. I gave you a scientific definition. The mind comprises of the brain, main information processing center. The brain is the primary center for the regulation of and control of body activities, receiving and interpreting, transmitting information into muscle and body organ. So, what's about the living? I'm looking at the rest of it. I'm looking at the rest of it. But I want you to understand something. We are talking about the mind. God did not make a mistake by creating the mind. Our entire life is controlled and directed by our mind. Sorry. The life that you and I we are living on the face of the earth today, the reason for which you are living, to where you are now, your personality is your mind that takes you there. The mind plays a vital role when it comes to the human life. God does not overload the mind. God doesn't play with the mind. This is why when even Jesus came on the scene, the Bible said, let this man which was in Christ, let it be in you. It will come to interest you. Sometimes God moves, sometimes God cries in your side. And you ask questions about the way they see God cry. No, it doesn't mean that God cries, when God moves. The feelings that God has, because God expects us. The position that God has placed me in, man is not operating in a class. God made me and put me in first class. If we go back to the book of beginning, the Bible says when God created the entire universe, when it came to the issue of man to create man, the Bible said God created man in his image and after his likeness. And then God breathed into what he has formed, the clay that he has formed. And then became a living soul. God took himself and placed himself into the clay. And what I'm going to interest you, it is based upon the first thing that God created, because he was operating in that class, he and God function at the same level. Adam and God function in the same way. Do you know that mental part in creation? Think of this. Mental part in creation. The Bible says when God created the animals, the fowls of the air, and the beasts of the field, and every other thing, the cattle, he brought them to Adam. No wonder Adam. Adam was operating in the class of God. Whatsoever name that Adam gave to any of those animals is the name that is still buried on them. They Adam go to God to consult God. Adam have the mind of God. But for this day, God has given 100% of his intellect of what he God thinks and how he God wants to function and how he God wants to operate. But we come to impress you, man, it's only operating 5%. And think of this. Well, let me know where today the word is conforming day by day. the world is going to speak. See what technology has done. But it's just 5%. It's just what? 5%. Last night I was reading and I began to read the scripture and I began to do some study on the mind. I mean, I came to the place to know about the brain. A recent scientist discovered that the information the brain can carry is more than what the computer can carry. But recent discovery, the information this brain can carry is more than what the computer can carry. Think of this. I've said it in this church before, when God created man and when God was about to separate the land among the sons of Adam, he only gave boundary. God is the one that created the universe, but when it comes to interesting, do you know that man created environment? Hello? It's man who created environment, it's not God. God only gave the condition of the land, but it is man who created the environment. And so, if you want to live in a conducive environment, it is your own responsibility to put your brain to work to cause that environment to change to become conducive.
Amen.
The reason for which many today they are yearning to go to Europe or go to America is because the people are putting their brain to work every day. The weather is not different for you. For the matter of fact, if you do studies, everything on the human body is on the weather. The only difference is just in front of you. Show me a man who was born superior, or show me a child that was born with that power, and I will tell you, we won't so be superior and won't so be subordinate. Failure on our part to work on this brain, which is our mind. Now I go back to our definition. We said the mind is mere faculty of reasoning, and it holds the power of imagination. Let me tell you about the mind. Let me bring it to our baby, our layman understanding. The mind is just like a computer. Those of you who are computer students, science students. The computer you see there, the computer will not do anything of its own. The web man created the computer will not do anything of its own. The computer is not programmed to receive information. Grab information, process it, and produce it. That is the word of the computer. And it will come to interest you. The computer receives information to process it and release it. But the computer also has the capacity to grab images also. The reason for which we are using mobile phone today is everybody taking phone. I mean taking pictures. You know what the women have to put a thing about and how to put camera in the screen? Because this particular phone is a computer. It has a device in it that when somebody scan, you take that image, you can put it in a particular phone, and it gets any area you can go. Those of you are women who can always send your photo on Facebook. It gets any area where you can clean the photo, right? And when you clean your photo, then when somebody see your photo on and maybe on Facebook, they see it, they say, yeah, wow. But there's an instrument that has been built in. So equally so is our mind. The mind is there to receive information and also there to receive images. Many of you, I think a few years ago, our bishop preached on image, the web of image. Listen to me, there are images that have been projected in the atmosphere. And the image that you grab and you process is what that image you receive. When it comes to our own life, the image that God has created you to be, and you don't grab that image, you can never be that image. Are you listening to what I'm saying?
Yes.
The image that you grab about your own, now what God word says about you, if you grab that image, is what you will be. And this is why many of us are struggling. Are you understanding what I'm saying? I pray that the Holy Spirit will help us to understand. The images that will grab in our life. Some of us are not thinking the way God thinking about us. Some of us are not seeing ourselves the way God sees us. We are still seeing ourselves to be somebody
thought was in the book of Jeremiah. Man thought he was not a thought of evil. But to give you an what? An expected what?
Amen.
An expected what?
Amen.
So if you don't have an expectation, if you don't go on pathfinding mission, in the word of God, what God will say concerning you, to bring that image that you are the head and not the tail, that you are above and not beneath, and to see yourself in our class and in our realm, you can never get it. So the image you grab is the image you become. Still alive, don't have an amazing testimony. You must see. You know what God told Abraham? God believed in the power of the man so much, he told Abraham, after Abraham crossed him, was celebrated, and in love was celebrated. He said, Abraham, as far as you can see, I will give you. Two of us. And wherever Abraham will reach, God gave it to him as possession. The next thing about this, God wanted you to use the power of the mind. Abraham was struggling that God, I will be challenged, I will not have child, and who will take care of my property about that? God said, look at you. God took him and said, look in the sky. If you can count the sky of the sky, so your descendant will be. When Abraham began to grab those images of the sky, the next thing God took him on the seashore and showed him the same. Can you count the grain of sand on the ground? He said, so shall your descendants be. When Abraham grabbed the images, Abraham began to walk with that image and everywhere he went. His name was Abraham, which means exalted father. But when he grabbed the image, and when he got in alignment with God's will and God's word for his life, Abraham went and walked for him. He said, my name is no longer Abraham, my name is Abraham. Which means father of many nations. He had not had an heir. But he went upon that, he declared himself as what? Father of God? Father of God? Abraham grabbed the image. That is why I love the account of Romans. Romans said, Romans chapter 4. It said, hope against all. Abraham believed because he saw the image of God. That God has made the father of the image. What is the image that you grabbed in the day? In your own life. What are you seeing today? That 1 or 2 years from now, 3 years from now, what do you want to see yourself in? So Paul the apostle in Romans, let me just say to our text, Paul the apostle in the church in Romans, in Rome. Paul was ministering in the church in Rome because there were a lot of activities, and the activities of the world were suggesting to the people of God, suggesting to the Christians. And Paul went on to teach them. He said, be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove. The first word of proof. God is not a man that you should lie. Yes. Hello, somebody. Amen. God is not a man that you should lie. Thousands of years ago, what God spoke is still coming to pass. I believe the word of God so much. To the sin that listen, one of my favorite scriptures in the Bible is Isaiah 54. Verse 10. The Bible says, declare the end at the beginning that in ancient time is canceled by sin. So what you will be in the future is what God revealed to you when you watch it. For those of you who are ministered. Every time God for you, he will give you the sound of motivation. But you want you to grab that image, you want you to grab that concept. What are you seeing concerning your life? We believe we live in a world today that the world is full and not projecting out of evil images. And some of you are grabbing those images. But I will come to the stage, I will show you how to get rid of those images. But what I want you to understand, God has provided an instrument. Tell to somebody and say, God has provided an instrument. For the development of your life. As the man thinketh in his heart, so is he. The spirit of the man may say, but why there is no vision? In all of those of us who don't have images, those of us who don't have picture, we don't have a proper picture of our future, we hang around it. The first way is start from the mind. Then you put it on paper. The reason you have to put it on paper is because God wants you to forget. forget. You want to look at everything you are doing motivated.
How do you want to have a dream?
When there is no dream, then people want. When there is no big dream, there is no vision. So it is expected of you, it is expected of me for us to have a clear dream. If not, I have a clear one now. God is not looking at you now. 10 years and a value for your life will be the same. You are discouraging God. You are beating the heart of God. Everything that Jesus did, Jesus has come. He has paid all the price. In everything that we need, God has made it available. But He wants us to use the instrument which is our mind. And if I didn't see mind, God gave us wisdom. How to use it. And we get wisdom from the word of God. But the first thing, you have to grab the image. So we don't have any picture of our future. And the reason is someone will tell us maybe the way what Jesus, what the apostle Jesus said, we are not stable. We are unstable. So then you see someone on another day, in your mind, yeah, I wish I could be here. After a few days, I don't know, oh, I wish I could be here. So now you become like Jack or Audrey or Master or what? Center of life, I want to say to us, God has given us an instrument which is our mind. God wants you to use the mind. God wants you to think like Him. God wants you to operate like Him. Now, let me tell you one of the philosophies of the world today. That no one can get rich. We're all becoming corrupt, or we're all doing something. It's a black lab on the feet of God. If God is the creator of the universe, He said the 1,000 cattle on the hill, they are mine. He owns the resources in the land. If God tells you, say, the earth is mine, and the fullness thereof, you think God can be in the world. But God wants you to think the starting point, the fulcrum, the starting point, is what you should grab the image. You should grab what? We talk about an amazing testimony, but so we not even imagine anything. There is nothing in our computer. I don't know how we call it, computer print. In our system, you know, we cannot put anything there, so we can't expect anything. The monitor, which is the television, I'm going to sit in front of you, call it the monitor, and the CPU that all my other information can pass through. You cannot put anything there, then you expect for something to come up. And I'm telling you, there are images, there are pictures, there are photos that are going over in the realm of the spirit. You need to start dropping them.
Amen.
I don't know whether this teaching is very hard, but I believe in God that the Holy Spirit Himself will interpret. Because in a year of amazing testimony, you won't have testimony if you are not envisioning anything about your life. Amen. And at that point, the scripture, God said to Jeremiah, my thought was not the thought of evil, but to give you what? An expected thing. So what you expect is what God wants to give you. What are you expecting? What are you expecting? And you have heard all the powerful messages. We have preached all the powerful messages. Bishop who have preached, he has opened on himself by the living of God's Spirit. But yet it's this one on year in, year out. There is no picture of it. The instrument that God has given you for you to live a successful life, you are not doing anything about it. And let me tell you one of the secrets. And many of us will subscribe to it. The day I read it on the internet. A little boy came from school, went in the basement, and while he was sitting there, every time he came from school, he went in the basement. In school, he was not very good. But every time he was in the basement, so this day he came from school, he went in the basement, as usual. And one of these are looking for your own work. Calling. I find that I say he answered. I mean, she went to the business, she saw him. You are here and I'm looking for your own, I'm calling you. What are you doing? Only two words here, mother. Mother, I'm team. Can you team? And by statistic, we have 100% in the world today, we have only 15% are thinking, 5% are implementing. The 85% are doing nothing about their lives. Then we have many people. You will pay all the time, you will pay all the money, you will lay all the money. door person. And I said that last Sunday. I said God is the creator of the rich and the poor, but he did not put them in that position.
Yes.
Each one of them got into that position by their deliberate action and their decision they made. I even told you a story, those of you who were here, someone said last week. I told you about the story of the ball, the little ball I got before, right?
Yes.
A friend told me, he said, you are not part of the class. That alone provoked me. He came home, he was crying. The father came from where? He said, Father, I want to get rich. The father didn't answer you, but the father went. After some night, he came back. Why do you want to get rich? He said, I was humiliated, my life, I was humiliated. Can you imagine my friend and I, we can move together? He and his friend, he and his family were going to go. I decided to get on the car, he told me, I'm not part of the class. That, and I know this is not our class. And he went towards it and he began to shh. The man, as the man tinker in his mouth, as to picture it, so you will be.
Yes.
Listen to me, listen to the light. Hey, Jesus will come back. I told myself, I'm not standing before you, I'm not preaching to God, I want to can draw somebody I'm saying here. Every day I'm asking God and I'm preparing myself for it. I will be another David that will sell history in my generation.
Yeah.
Not because I'm singing for you. That have been in my prayer, that have been in my diary, no, I will be another David that will sell my history for my generation. God is the one that's supposed to do it. No! God gave you an instrument to make it to be what it's supposed to be. But you are refusing to work on it.
Thank you.
Let me close. I have 5 minutes. Let me close with this. There are 3 words that we mentioned over there in Romans chapter 12, verse 2. It says that here may one proof. Why is the word the good? Now, God will go towards the entire group, the entire humanity. The good way of God is that the sun, the rain, shine on everybody, right?
Yes.
Hello?
Ah.
Why are you wicked? Why are you bad? Everybody enjoy that blessing. That is a good way of God. So now you have the thing without breath. The sun, the rain. For everybody, that's the good of God towards men. The acceptable word of God is by moving in the direction of accepting His Son who will show you the way. Hello?
Ah.
And there are many are not grounded. The acceptable word of God. What is the acceptable word of God? God wanted to accept His Son Jesus as the author and the finisher of your life. Hello? Wait, that's not the one. The acceptable way of God for you to accept His Son Jesus as the one, the author, and the finisher of your life. Then that will show you now that you are on path. Then we come to the third part. The perfect will of God. What is the perfect will of God? You are ought to be operating in a sixth class sense. I always told people the world is operating on 5 senses. So we've got a 5 class, or 5 classes. But you, as a believer, you have what we call what? The 6 senses. How do we call it? How do we call it? But in school, I know many of you did it, and students are still doing it. We got a 5 senses, right? And how many animal rays are using, right? But now for you, believer, you are privileged to enter the perfect word of God, you must use the 6 senses. And what is the 6 senses? The Holy Spirit will be leading you to do what He's supposed to do. That others have not done. And He will be asking you how did you do it.
Thank you.
I said it the other day, Lord, God will be moving, God will get angry with us. Can you imagine we are in an era and the fulfillment of divine prophecy? I said it last week, Sunday. I said that the time is coming that the church is the one that's going to be boring the government. All the government around the world, the governments will come to the church, to pray for the church. But the church will be capacitated. So this is why every time we teach our people, any field of life, we have journalists, we have military personnel, we have lawyer, we have even in the political arena, everybody has to come preach. But it starts from the church. You know what it is? What the church has to be praying to government? It's part of the divine prophecy. People will be coming from many, people will be coming from different nations to come to the church and say, we want to know the way. All these things that are happening in the world, the economic crisis all over the world, the global economy, it's part of prophecy. And God wouldn't tell you that it's time for the church to arise. You know what Isaiah was saying, arise and shout? Because you know that the world will be what? A gross darkness. The world will never get better. Then somebody said the world will never get better. But in the midst of the chaotic situation, God wants for the church to read. And if the church is not operating at the frequency and the level of the instrument that God has given the church, the church will never reach that place. I'm bringing you classroom today because the Holy Spirit wants you to understand in this year of our amazing testimony, what are you having in your computer, which is your life? And I close with this. Jesus said, show me a man who has faith. Now, I have given you the picture that you should have the picture. So write it down. Whatever you know that you want to do in 3 years, you should have put on when you're doing a success conference. You told all you wrote it down. And I'm telling you also, write it down, write that dream down. And the next time, wait for what's it. Wait for what's it and see. Says of God. God is depending on you. Tell you somebody say God is depending on you. The mind. Let me read this particular passage of scripture that we just read. Let me close with it. In the New Living Translation Bible, Romans chapter 12, verse 2, it says, do not copy the behavior and custom of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think. Baba, changing the way you are. And someone has been thinking this way. I give my very old family background, so nobody in my family, I won't get rich. So I know it is not possible for me to get rich. And if you are that person, I want you to change that mind. I want you to delete that thing. You know, in your computer, whatever information you put there, you don't delete it, what you do? You delete it, right? You delete it. Yeah, don't even allow it to be the recycle being said. Delete the whole thing, or reformat. I got a message before from a relation and I'm preaching the church. They call him downloading to decode. You download from the rent and you can't decode it for function. Stay on your feet.